Hello, I'm presenting on behalf of Virtual Health, a growing startup that provides software as a service. To healthcare insurance companies. But the problem we are presenting is not specific to healthcare. In many applications, transactional data became less relevant to daily operations with age. In contrast, as historical data volumes grow, data become more valuable for analytics. Here we described the relational data lake approach for storing daily read-only snapshots of transactional databases. To lower the costs, we chose MariaDB column store because of its inherent data compression and Amazon Web Services S3 storage support. A crucial data lake aspect is retaining the stored data in its original form and format. I will elaborate more on the importance of this aspect later in the slides. Another problem we are addressing here is not unique to virtual health. Operational systems in healthcare are complex and not directly suitable for analytics or machine learning algorithms. We chose to build data pipeline to MariaDB column store since it already provides open source examples of integration with Jupyter Notebooks and Apache Zeppelin, popular open source tools used for analytics. To conclude the introduction, I remind you of a known problem of executing analytical queries on a transactional database. To address this problem, a special storage format, columnar, can significantly improve performance of analytical queries. In this talk, we will focus on MariaDB column store and compare its performance to InnoDB. Why some queries are inherently slow in transactional databases? Let us find top 10 clients who visited doctors most often. Such ranking queries are known to be hard for relational database technologies. Thus, it is not surprising that this query is so slow. What about indexing? But the query is already using index, as shown on the query explained plan. Let us add another index. Indeed, adding our index does help, but the query is still slow, particularly for a user interface. But the first ranking query was only the beginning. How about the second ranking queries? Ranking clients by medical bills. Please note that multiple table joins are not uncommon when the schema is highly normalized for transactional performance. You must be truly patient to get the result. It took over 9 hours to learn that a client experienced one of the most expensive treatments. Let me summarize why our analytical queries were slow in the transactional environment. This is because most relational databases, such as MariaDB, are row-oriented. If a query needs 3 columns, it will read the entire row. InnoDB organizes tables by 16K pages, resulting in even more data to be read in. And MySQL will use only 1 CPU core per query. Although this limitation is now starting to change, and you may read more about this from the link provided on this page. In case of the first ranking query, the row-oriented databases must read the entire row to get the data for just 3 columns. In contrast, The column-oriented databases read only the data from the three columns needed by the query. Now, let me present the results of our comparison of the InnoDB performance versus ColumnStore. The comparison was done using two different Amazon EC2 instances, the minimally recommended instance and the larger instance optimal for our queries. And here we present results for the latest ColumnStore GA release available. I will discuss status of more recent releases later. What about the first ranking query? There is no large difference since the added covered index is essentially an equivalent of the ColumnStore reading data from just three columns. However, our conclusion is that the ColumnStore is preferable since you cannot add covered indices for more of your ad hoc analytical queries. What about the very large query? Let us find out. Well, this query is indeed challenging. The extra tuning is necessary. The solution is to allow the disk-based joins. After the column story restart, we are ready to try again, and wow, even with the disk-based joins, the column store performance is more than two orders of magnitude faster. The performance can be improved even further when the joins fit in memory. Another column store benefit is a reduced storage. In our case, we observed an overall factor of 4. Half of that is due to a compression. We have a lot of binary data, encrypted, protected health information that are not expected to compress well. Another half if from indices removal. With such an impressive performance gain, we clearly need to transfer data to the column store. But how? Let me present the data transfer in terms of the traditional framework of extract, transform, and load approach. Since MariaDB column store has a InnoDB built-in, we use an asynchronous replication slave as our data staging area. As I noted before, the crucial data lake feature is minimized data transformation to retain the original format. For the data load, we found a simple but elegant approach. Stop replication, load data using in parallel the internal very efficient binary data transfer. Then resume the replication. In essence, we implemented the so-called ELT instead of the traditional ETL. But as a first step in our approach, one must extract, transform, and load the database schema itself. In the first approximation, it is rather simple. You just replace engine InnoDB with column store. However, such naive approach doesn't work out of the box. This slide lists certain steps you need to take to eliminate DDL differences, such as the absence of explicit indices in the column store. For those data types that are not supported, we used the replacements listed on this slide, but with more data type became supported, the last two replacements are no longer needed in the recent releases. I will discuss those releases at the very end. Here we list some other differences we encountered. Some of these are legacy and not needed in the original schema. Also, the generated or virtual columns are not supported. We omit virtual columns since they have no additional data. But those differences were rather trivial. Here we need to dive deeper as it relates to subtle differences in the known issue with null values versus empty strings for certain data types. As documented, the implicit default value for string types is an empty string. Here we are converting the schema to column store as is. But as also documented, the column store treats a zero length string as a null value. As a result of these features, during data transfer, you will get an error as shown on the slide. To resolve this issue, more schema tweaking is needed. You may need to remove the not null for columns for all string data types. Now, the most advanced part of the presentation, data import. Here are more technical details about the approach. As documented, it is using very efficient binary data transfers behind the schemes. In certain cases, you may need to execute such command lines yourself, as we described in the next slides. This is because the internal approach may not work for you, as it provides no interface to control the separator, such as in cases of data having the backslash character. To debug such failures, please look at the error files generated in your data directory. For those cases, we use the command lines shown on the slide. Also, we had to switch to the command line to increase the read buffer, as shown on the slide. Here is another case to use the command line to preserve the original data values, since by default, the column store will replace null values with zero for the nullable integer or date and time columns. Also, for the very large tables, you may encounter the error shown on the slide. In that case, you just need to tune the configuration further as described. Our final advice is to disable the binary logging. Otherwise, you will accumulate huge binary logs volumes during data import. To summarize, let me clarify first on the numerous issues that we described in our previous slides. Please do not get the wrong impression that column store is an emerging product with many associated issues. On the contrary, the successful load of healthcare data to column store is attesting to its level of maturity. The healthcare records are notoriously complex. You may peek at this complexity by looking at a couple of open source electronic health records projects that have about 200 tables each. The virtual health database schema is on par with more comprehensive commercial electronic health record systems that have three times as much tables and thousands of columns. Summarizing, let me conclude that the relational data lake we built with MariaDB column store retains the source data in their original format. We observed analytical query speedup of more than two orders of magnitude, and the native MariaDB protocol lowers application integration barriers. Thus, we are evaluating the latest MariaDB community server version that includes the column store plugin with S3 storage support. Although it took only a year between the major column store community releases, the changes between them are significant. Because the latest MariaDB column store underwent significant refactoring. From MariaDB 10.5.4, it is available is the storage engine for MariaDB server. Before then, it is only available as a separate download. But the latest official Docker image from MariaDB does not have column store storage engine. You could check the storage engine by the show plugin command. The reason is a separate maturity level for storage engine versus MariaDB server itself. A special build includes storage engines that are not GA level of maturity. Another innovation is that the column store is now managed by the systemd. On the other hand, the systemd is against the grain of the Docker approach itself. As a result, your own Docker image is needed to learn latest column store version syntax and features. This is problematic since encountering an issue in your own Docker image, you have to reproduce it with the official column store distribution installed elsewhere, such as in a VirtualBox. In addition to column store refactoring, MariaDB version upgrade introduces new defaults like a strict transaction table for SQL mode. And the very latest Gamma version introduces new features like alter table. Also, certain behavior changed. I was unable to find the informative error files available in the beta version when we have a kind of errors like internal errors. Thus, my advice is not to wait for the latest column store general availability release. Start evaluating beta gamma releases now. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?